After cutting key interest rates by 25 basis points at the first monetary policy meeting of the year in early February, the Philippine Central Bank said the COVID-19 outbreak in China would only result in a reduction of 0.3% in economic growth in the first half of 2020. Now that COVID-19 has found its way to more countries outside of China, Philippine Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokno says they are rethinking that forecast.
I gave instruction to Deputy Governor Dakila to maybe revisit the estimate. So we're not finished yet. The impact is that if it's one quarter, if there's a V-shaped recovery, it will be 0.2, right? So an average of 0.3, if it's one semester, two quarters.
For the initial estimate of COVID-19's economic impact, the BSP had looked at trade and tourism, as well as the 2003 SARS outbreak, as guidance. Now they will also be looking at a wider range of data, including investment inflows. COVID-19 has also affected global financial markets, including the Philippine Stock Exchange. Julian Tarabago of ATR Asset Management says so much of the Philippine economy can be affected by COVID-19, including a sizable portion of the Philippine Stock Exchange Index.
In terms of manufacturing and tourism, those sectors account for roughly 30% of the PSEI, and we're talking about impact on malls, accommodation, airlines, and food service, etc. And our preliminary numbers suggest that the impact on GDP, if this extends to June 2020, will be about 50 basis points, meaning if we were looking at about 6.3% GDP growth for full year 2020, there would be a reasonable, at this point, a reduction to possibly 5.8%.
Jokno, however, says they do not believe COVID-19 will pull Philippine GDP growth below 6% this year, and government will do as much as possible to ensure growth remains high, including more than forecast reductions in key interest rates.
We're confident that we'll still hit 6% this year. We're confident that we'll still hit 6%. Because most of the things we plan to do are not heavily affected by the coronavirus, like the bill.
The only thing that could stand in the way of more monetary policy adjustments would be accelerating inflation. The Philippine Central Bank will release its inflation forecast for February on Friday. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.